Hi, and welcome to Rhetoric. I never in my life thought I would be owning a sound blaster for the micro-channel architecture. Well, here we are. Today, we are going to talk about this sound blaster replica for the PS2 with MCA bus made by David Larson. If you have ever tried finding a sound blaster for the microchannel bus, you know it's close to impossible.
The microchannel bus was something IBM invented for the PS2 range of machines. It was supposed to be better than the ISA bus, and it should give IBM more control over the PC market. As we know, it was not a success.
With the IBM PS2, you want a network up and network down.
For me, the MCA bus was a showstopper when it came to using my PS2 machines for gaming. This was because the MCA version of the Sound Blaster cost a fortune, even back then. And today, they are just impossible to get, until now. We can see that it's a MCA-based card on the bus connectors and the bracket. It is inspired by the Snarkbarker MCA, but with some improvements. This chip is the YM3812, or most commonly known as the OPL2. And the larger one to the left is the DSP chip, used for digital sound playback. This is essentially what makes the Sound Blaster a Sound Blaster card and not just an ad-lib. Further, the card has a microphone input and a joystick connector with a non-MPU401 compatible MIDI interface. And lastly, the card has place for two SAA 1099 chips for CMS, or Creative Music System, compatibility. Sadly, this does not work yet. Maybe it will be fixed in the future. If you are into CMS, check out my video on the Sound Blaster 1.5 replica, also from David Larson. I asked myself if this was a replica of the CT5320 or the CT5330 card. It's not that obvious. According to this Wikipedia article, the CT5330 or Sound Blaster Pro 2 has the stereo OPL3 chip. And since our card uses OPL2, it should be a CT5320. Well, as we can see in the article, the 5320 has a problem on CPUs running faster than 16 MHz, and it has a joystick issue, none of which I have had when using this card in my PS2 model 55SX. Other improvements to the original card is a feature for routing the sound output to the MCA bus for use on other audio cards or the internal speaker. It also has three CD-ROM inputs and an internal line-level output. That last thing is not printed on the card, so I had to ask David about it. David's card does not support a software mixer to set the volumes for the FM, mic, CD, etc. This came with the CT5330 card. So, in my opinion, David's card is a CT5320 without the bugs and with some improvements. This is the machine we will be using. It's my 55SX running a 386 at 16 MHz. As you probably know, we need to use a reference disk for configuring our PS2 system with a new device. Also, we need to download the ADF file from David's website and copy that to the reference floppy. The configuration is quite self-explanatory. Worth mentioning again is the feature for routing the sound output from the Sound Blaster card to the MCA bus, where it can be picked up by other sound cards or the PC speaker. But since the volume of the internal speaker is low and the hard drive and power supply fan is loud, this is not a feature I will be using. At the first attempt of using this card, I had a problem that almost was a showstopper for me. The background noise of the amplified speaker out on the back was terrible. Actually, it was not usable in my opinion. But luckily, the fix was easy. I had to connect my speakers using the internal line out. Now the noise levels are okay. Not as good as David's Soundblaster 1.5 for the Isobus, but much better than my Soundblaster Pro 2, also for the Isobus. It is so satisfying to finally being able to play a game on this PS2 machine. I never collected PS2 machines because they were unusable to play games, but now I will reconsider. I already regret all the PS2 machines I've turned down over the years. If you have a IBM PS2 with microchannel, there's nothing to think about. You want this card. But I have a couple of suggestions to David.
This was fun. But before we end this video, there are a few issues we should talk about. First of all, this sound card really needs a line out on the back, on the bracket of the card. And since this sound card doesn't support the software mixing, you don't have an option to turn off the CD in or mic in inputs. This card should have a couple of jumpers for that. I think that could reduce the noise level even more. Third, the noise level for the amplified speaker out on the bracket is way too high. So that should be fixed. And fourth, the volume knob is way too close to the end of the computer, so it's hard to reach. Or maybe just skip number 3 and 4 on my list and just remove the amplified speaker out, and therefore also removing the volume knob. David is also working on an XT IDE for the microchannel bus. I really look forward to trying that out. If these things are things that you like, I would urge you to subscribe to my channel and also hit the notify button so you don't miss out on any of my new videos. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. Thank you for watching.